beautiful day in California. Out here, I'm one of the good guys. But good and bad can be in the eye of the beholder.
All the leaves are brown.
John Sugar.
And the sky is gray.
I'm a private investigator.
They told me that you do one thing and one thing only. You find the missing.
Hey there.
Hey, Maya.
Hi, how are you guys? Thanks
good
so much
lady.
For being on the top with me today. Audrey, just want to jump right in. This series has been described as genre bending. Without giving too much of that away, what do you want viewers to take away from that term genre bending?
Well, I think it's more that it's, you know, we are balancing a couple things in our show. We're trying to tell a classic noir detective story while creating a modern take on it, you know? Yeah. And so Fernando Morales brought this unique, distinctive visual style and aesthetic to the show. And so when you see those things kind of come together, I think, you know, that creates its own almost language and genre in and of itself.
Mm. That makes a lot of sense. So the show is set in the world of Hollywood. And was there a conscious decision? It could have been set in the world of sports. It could have been set in the world of art collecting. Sugar's a huge movie fan and the Siegel family is involved in that business. Was that a conscious decision to stick with that industry?
Very conscious. And you said it comes from character. It comes from the fact that Sugar loves movies and it's the way he sees the world. And so him actually entering the world of movie making of Hollywood is complicated for him because it actually starts to actually change the way he looks at movies. And what was fun for us as people who work in film, as people who love film and the history of film, was that the Siegel family allows us to tell the story of Hollywood over three generations. It's this dynastic family that gets a start in classic Hollywood, you know, sort of the glamour and glitz of the heyday of Hollywood, back down from Jonathan Siegel to his son, Bernie, who's kind of in the more debased money first Hollywood, to their grandson, Davey, who's in the really dark and twisted, you know, sex and drug addled part of Hollywood. And you see the way that it's transformed, devolved over the years. And we were able to tell that whole story because we're investigating this family.
Sure. It's beautifully filmed. It's noir to the nth degree. But I'm wondering, Simon, for you, coming off the heels of the phenomenal success of X-Men and Invasion, how was it telling a quieter story?
I love all kinds of stories. And I specifically, I've always loved detective stories. I grew up reading detective fiction, all kinds of detective fiction. I started with classics, Agatha Christie, Conan Doyle, and then I was reading Jim Thompson and James Ellroy and writers from the 70s. And I worked on the Sherlock Holmes movies and I produced the Agatha Christie Poirot movies. It's always been a genre that I've loved. Each of the different versions of detectives always has their own unique specific tone to it. And so I loved in this that it was a really much more of a character piece where you were really investigating and exploring the detective as much as you were the crime. And that required a sort of contemplative, really character first approach, which I loved because you could just focus on performance, on the humanity of the characters, on the emotion of the characters. And I it was exciting to be able to sort of deep dive into moments. The show has propulsion and momentum and, you know, all of that, but it didn't feel like it was being driven by story. It was really being driven by character.
Mm-hmm. Now, Simon, I read up on you and I know that your first love is writing, but, you know, being a producer, you like to get in there and mix it up with mm-hmm. the writers. Did you have an opportunity to get your hands on any scripts? Did you do any writing for this series?
I did not do any writing for the series. Oh. We had extraordinary writers working on it. I mean, honestly, I really do love producing, but the thing I like the most about producing is getting to work with other writers.
Right.
I spent a decade or two of my life as a screenwriter writing movies, and you never get to work with other writers when you're making movies. But you do as a producer, and you do in television. And so the fun for me is getting to work with some of my favorite writers. And Mark Protasevich is a writer I've known about for a very long time and never met. I've always loved his writing. And so it was just a pleasure to get to give notes. We would give notes, thoughts, and Mark would execute them and execute them beautifully. And we'd other writers in the show that were extraordinary as well. I never opened up Final Draft on this one.
Okay. And one final question, and both of you all can answer, and I hope it's a yes. Can I have the car? I want the car.
You can. I mean, we can't give it to you, but it's out there. It's out there. If you Google it, you'll find it somewhere. Yeah, we would like it too.
Yeah, it's a gorgeous car, gorgeous film. I mean, series. It's filmed beautifully. We're so excited for it. I binged it in like 4 or 5 hours. It's such a great show. So thank you for your time. And thanks for sitting with me today.
Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.